Hold up, before you watch this video, make sure that you check out part one, which is on the channel Coast Your Craziness. I worked with my friend Tyler on this video, and he, of course, has the channel Coast Your Craziness, and we uploaded part one on that channel. So go check it out right here. You won't really get many of the jokes, as well as some of the stuff that we talk about in this video if you don't watch part one, so go check it out. And also, of course, if you like roller coasters and amusement parks, then make sure to subscribe to this channel because I upload new videos kind of like this one every single week. Also, comment down below because I respond to every single comment that I see. Anyways, let's roll the intro. Peace out. Whoa. What kind of ending was that? As mentioned in part one, there were actually supposed to be another coaster built in 2000 in addition to Superman Krypton Coaster. But the track pieces ended up just sitting there behind Poltergeist, not moved at all. This coaster was rumored to be named Boardwalk Canyon Blaster and was a Zier Tivoli coaster. This ride ended up being shipped to the other side of the planet and opened as Tom E. Jerry at Parque Warner Madrid in 2002. You can still find this coaster, which they frickin' stole from us, in operation today. There will always be a mystery of why the coaster wasn't built at Fiesta Texas. It may have just been a small coaster, but it would have been a big deal. Hashtag size doesn't matter.
2001 wasn't at all a big year for Fiesta Texas. After their big boom in 1999 and 2000, the park took sort of an off year. They ended up removing Screamin' Sky Coaster, an upcharge attraction from the Fiesta Bay Boardwalk, but they did add Turbo Bungee, a small attraction that allowed riders to strap into a bungee and bounce around. The park also had the luxury of winning the Golden Ticket Awards for Best Theme Park Shows for the third year in a row.
2002 was a sad year for Joker's Revenge fans. The Vekoma Hurricane Coaster was closed and shipped to Six Flags New Orleans, where it opened in 2003 and operated for the rest of its lifetime. And if anyone was wondering why the model is named a hurricane coaster, well, here's why. Some good news, though, came to Rattler fans when the whole coaster got retracked, causing riders to no longer have to go to the doctor afterward. Also, Poltergeist got new and improved trains, substituting its over-the-shoulder restraints with just a lap bar and a seatbelt. The park did end up replacing the Sky Coaster with a Gravity Works skyscraper attraction called Tempest. They also added the Sally Dark Ride Scooby-Doo Ghost Blasters, which is a shooting dark ride, to the Fiesta Bay Boardwalk area. And for the fourth year in a row, the park won the Best Theme Park Shows category in the Golden Ticket Awards.
2003 saw the removal of Wipeout, a Chance Rides Wipeout. The park also got two Golden Ticket Awards at the end of that season. For the fifth year in a row, they won the award for Best Theme Park Shows, obviously, but they also had the honor of having the best floorless coaster, Superman Krypton Coaster. The park did not do anything else, though.
2004 saw the absolutely amazing addition of the insanely chill, beautiful, but pretty terrible at spelling, me. Oh wait, but the park? Oh, the park didn't get sh- But they did win best shows again. The 2005 edition didn't even come close to beating out the edition of 2004. The super cringy and not nearly as cool Tyler was born. Ew.
Hey!
Fiesta Texas, though, saw the removal of Turbo Bungee and Chaos. And once again, the park was greedy and kept the Golden Ticket Award for themselves for the seventh year in a row.
For the 2006 season, the water park was renamed Whitewater Bay and got some new water slides. But another year of closures was brought upon Tempest and Wipeout from the dry park, And guess what? They won the golden ticket again. Yay. 2007 finally brought one of the best coasters to the park.
Tony Hawk's Big Spin.
Ah! Yes! You got it wrong! You got it wrong! How does it feel?
I don't know, Mr. Tatler. How does it feel? That's right.
Tony Hawk's Big Spin was a Gerstlauer spinning coaster that was added to the Fiesta Bay Boardwalk area as a fun family ride. The ride takes you through many drops, hills, turns, and helixes, all while the car that you are in is spinning freely throughout the ride. This was an instant hit with the family audience at the park. Another big addition that year was the park's holiday celebration, Holiday in the Park, which finally returned after 10 years of being discontinued. And of course, they did again win Best Theme Park Shows in the Golden Ticket Awards.
2008 was the year that Six Flags Fiesta Texas got its well-deserved major coaster. Goliath, a B&M invert Batman the Ride clone, was relocated to Fiesta Texas after operating for 2 years at Six Flags New Orleans. 2 years! The ride takes riders on a two-minute ride reaching 105 feet in the air and 50 miles per hour. This ride throws you through five inversions, all while your legs are dangling below, or at some points, above you. Kinderwagen and Der Fliegende Circus were both removed from the Spaßburg area at the end of the 2008 season, and the carousel, Dornröschen, I don't even know how you say that, that was moved to Rockville, where it was renamed Amerigo-Round. And do we even have to talk about the Golden Ticket Awards at this point?
In 2009, Wiggles World opened as a re-theme of part of the Spaßburg area to a kid-friendly area. All attractions in that section of the park were either renamed or moved. The park also added Splish Splash Zone, Yummy Yummy Fruit Salad, and the Big Red Plains. Some Spaßburg rides were also renamed, including Die Fledermaus, which was renamed Whirligig, Steingas, which was renamed Fenderbender, and Der Twister, which was simply renamed The Twister. This kiddie area expansion was exactly what the park needed. 2010 was a very uneventful year for the park. Nothing was added or removed, and overall, nothing exciting happened.
Wait, what? No, but the shows! How could you, Dollywood? How could you?
In 2011, Six Flags ended its licensing program with Tony Hawk and the Wiggles. Because of this, many rides were renamed. Tony Hawk's Big Spin was renamed simply Big Spin, and in the Wiggles World area, which was renamed Kidsopolis, Romp Bompa Stomp was renamed Kitty Coaster, Wiggly Train was renamed Buckaroos, Big Red Cars was now Crazy Cars, Yummy Yummy Fruit Salad was now Up Up and Away, and Big Red Planes was now Zoom Jets. Okay, but seriously, who named these rides? Like, honestly. Anyways, Wagon Wheel was removed from Crack Axle Canyon to wrap up the 2011 season.
2012 brought the addition of Skyscreamer, which is a huge 200-foot star flyer that was put on the outskirts of the Spaßburg area. They also did some minor changes, like renaming Big Spin to Pandemonium, and SS Overboard was left standing but not operating. Finally, on August 4th, 2012, a very sad day came for Rattler fans around the state. Rattler gave its last rides before closing indefinitely. Coaster enthusiasts, though, became skeptical and excited as rumors for a revitalization of Rattler went wild. Many of them looked at the nearby Six Flags Over Texas, who had just gotten a new Texas Giant, an RMC coaster that was a revitalization of the old Texas Giant, and were expecting Rattler to get the same treatment.
On August 30th, 2012, Six Flags announced Iron Rattler, which was going to be a 179-foot tall RMC hybrid that would reimagine the layout of Rattler to have more intense airtime, crazy overbanked turns, and even a zero-G roll, the first on any hybrid coaster. Hype for Iron Rattler was through the roof as the coaster opened on May 25th, 2013. The ride is in the Crackaxle Canyon area and takes riders through an intense and thrilling experience, reaching speeds of 70 miles per hour at the bottom of its 171-foot drop. The coaster stands at 179 feet and goes through one inversion over its 3,266 feet of track. The whole ride is only about 45 seconds long, but it really packs a punch. Gunslinger, an upcharge attraction sling-style ride, also opened in the Crackaxle Canyon that year as a nice complement to Iron Rattler. The park did amazing that year as people were now flocking from all around the country to ride this crazy RMC, which, at the time of opening, was only one of three in the world.
2014 was definitely an off year for the park. Nothing was added to the dry park, but Motorama Turnpike was removed from the Rockville area. In late 2014, we found out what the replacement was going to be for Motorama, and it wasn't just going to be another kid's ride. Instead, it would be Batman the Ride, the first of many SNS 4D free spins. This ride would twist you forward and backwards on a free spinning axis, but does have some magnetic panels that forcibly flip the cars in some places in order to alleviate some forces that riders could experience. This was done as an improvement of Green Lantern First Flight, an Intamin Zack spin at Six Flags Magic Mountain, which didn't have these spin magnets, and therefore was deemed one of the worst coasters in America. Funny enough, Batman the Ride's track was actually manufactured by RMC, meaning that, in a way, Six Flags Fiesta Texas got two RMCs in a row.
On May 23rd, 2015, Batman the Ride opened to the public. This cheap ride got great reviews and was then added to many other Six Flags parks. The park also received some awesome new entertainment with Ovation in Zaragoza Theater, Final Countdown Rockville High, Hashtag iPop in Teatro Fiesta, and Lone Star Spectacular to top it all off. SS Overboard and Little Castaways were sadly removed from the Fiesta Bay Boardwalk area this year as well.
2016 came with the refurbishment of the Fiesta Bay Boardwalk area with refurbished wood, new lighting packages, and a flat ride package to replace the rides that were taken out in 2015. Hurricane Force 5, a Zamperla Disco, Spin Sanity, a Larson Tilt-A-Whirl, and Fireball, a Larson Superloop coaster,
it's not a coaster,
all opened in the Fiesta Bay Boardwalk area of the park. 2017, which marked the 25th anniversary for the park, came with a water coaster added to the water park called Thunder Rapids Water Coaster. In terms of the dry park, Power Surge was removed from the Rockville area. On August 30th, 2017, Six Flags announced the replacement for Power Surge. It would be the first ever single rail coaster. Made by RMC, this would be a prototype for their new Raptor model.
Standing at 113 feet tall, reaching speeds of 52 miles an hour, and going through three inversions on its 1,800 feet of track, Wonder Woman Golden Lasso Coaster opened on May 12, 2018. The giant McDonald's French fry is full of many snappy inversions, whippy turns, and strong ejector airtime. Also, wait, is that theming? This ride was one of two of these models opening in 2018, the other being a mirror image of Wonder Woman opening as Railblazer at California's Great America. Wonder Woman was deemed the first single rail coaster, though, because it opened 33 days before Railblazer. Suck it, California's Great America! Other things that happened in 2018 include closing Scooby-Doo, which was a dark ride in the Fiesta Bay Boardwalk area, which will always remain in my heart, and Twister, a Husk Top Spin, as well as refurbishing and repainting some rides. By the way, Wonder Woman was the third RMC tracked coaster at Fiesta Texas in a row. Mind-blowing, I know. Or should I say, mind-blowing.
2019 came with Joker, Carnival of Chaos, which opened as the world's tallest and fastest pendulum ride, standing at 172 feet tall and reaching speeds of 75 miles per hour. This Zamperla Giga Discovery also has a funhouse element, where riders can walk through a themed funhouse where they get engrossed in the Joker's devious acts. Plus, in an attempt to go along with the DC theme that the Rockville area of the park now has, Whirligig was renamed DC Supervillain Swing. On top of all of that, Pirates of the Deep Sea opened as a revitalization of Scooby-Doo, which closed the year before.
And finally, in 2020, Boomerang Coast to Coaster got retracked and repainted, making it a much more bearable ride experience. And Kitty Coaster was repainted and renamed Streamliner Coaster. This year is also supposed to come with the addition of the world's tallest ride of its kind, Daredevil Dive Flying Machines, a Zamperla Super Air Race. This ride is taking the place of Gunslinger, which will be moved to the boardwalk section of the park. The ride unfortunately may not open until 2021 because of delays due to the COVID-19 pandemic.
And that's it. So thank you guys so much for watching this video of the history and timeline of Six Flags Fiesta Texas. Fiesta Texas seems to have a very promising future, as it has been getting great new coaster additions every around 3 years. This video did take us forever to make, so make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and of course share this video with your friends so that more people can see the full timeline and history of Six Flags Fiesta Texas. Anyways, until next time, peace out.